الحمد لله رب العالمين وأصلي وأسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله ما بعد. I'll keep this example in Sahih al-Bukhari, the first hadith, إنما الأعمال بالنيات, to explain the different names of hadith used by the scholars. Sometimes you find the word منقطع. I'll make it bigger. منقطع, معضل, مرسل, معلق. Okay, we need to know these words, okay, because sometimes at the end of the hadith they say this hadith is منقطع, or this hadith is معضل, مرسل, معلق. Okay, literally what is the meaning of منقطع? If there is something cut, منقطع, والله the my shoes is منقطع. Okay, I mean if the thread of the shoes is cut, this is منقطع. معضل, okay, if there is something, يعني we say this is معضلة, it is very difficult. There is something, for example, in math, this equation is معضلة, يعني very difficult. طيب, مرسل, something released. Okay, يعني when we say, you know, if you want to keep your ship or your ark near the, يعني not to go with the sea. Okay, so you will tie the rope, and if you untie the rope and you keep it, we say mursal. It means your ship, there is a risk that it goes, so it is mursal. Or for example, if you are holding someone, طيب, then he tells you, release me, arsilni, يعني leave me to go, مرسل. معلق, if something hanged. Okay, if you hang something, معلق. طيب, let's see the meaning of these words in the hadith. Okay, معلق, if something hanged, if you hang something like this, you know, ثريا, what is the name of ثريا? Huh? In the masjid, the big one.
Chandelier.
Chandelier. طيب, This it is معلق. Han, yes. طيب. So this is one of the ahadith in Bukhari. This is a real chain. This is a real chain. Okay. Al-Bukhari said, حدثنا, my sheikh told me, my sheikh Abdullah bin Zubair. Then from his sheikh, or my sheikh heard his Sheikh Sufyan ibn Uyayna, and then Sufyan ibn Uyayna heard from Yahya ibn Sa'id al-Ansari, then Yahya ibn Sa'id al-Ansari heard from Muhammad Ibrahim Taymi, then he heard from Alqama ibn Waqqas al-Laythi, then from Umar Khattab, then from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is, if you remember, authentic chain, Bukhari. This chain Bukhari. طيب. They say, if you remove the beginning of the chain, the beginning, for example, you remove Bukhari, or you remove Bukhari and Abdullah ibn Zubair al-Humaydi, or you remove three, you remove four, okay?
Yes.
Okay. Can you keep it closer or it will not be clear? طيب. So if you remove, for example, Bukhari, or you remove Bukhari and Zubair, you remove something from the beginning, okay? Then we call it mu'allaq. Mu'allaq. So imagine we cover Bukhari and Abdullah Zubair, or Abdullah Zubair Humaydi. He's not at the Sahabi, not Sahabi. طيب. Or you remove three, or you remove all of them. Then imagine that the hadith will be mu'allaq. It is not fixed with the land. Okay? So this is the meaning of the hadith al-mu'allaq. What does it mean hadith mu'allaq? That we miss the first thing from the chain or more. Yani if we remove al-Bukhari from this chain, then it is mu'allaq. Okay? Or if you remove all of them, if you say, قَالَ النَّبِيُّ عَلَيْهِ الصَّلَاةُ وَالسَّلَامُ, this is mu'allaq. This is mu'allaq, okay? And this is one kind of the not authentic chains. Why? Because it is not complete. It is not complete. Mursal, okay, I will go to, I started from down. Okay, Mursal, if you say al-Bukhari, then Abdullah Zubair, then Sufyan Aina, then Yahya Sa'id, then Muhammad Ibrahim Taymi, then Alqama Ibn Waqqas, then you mention the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Alqama Ibn Waqqas, Sahabi or Tabi'i? Tabi'i. Alqama Ibn Waqqas Layti, he is Tabi'i. طيب. Umar al-Khattab, Sahabi. Companion. Alqama Ibn Waqqas, Tabi'i. طيب. Tabi'i means the second generation. The first generation, the companions. Sahaba. Umar al-Khattab, one of the first generation companions. Alqama Ibn Waqqas, Tabi'i. Tabi'i means he did not see the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, but he met the companions or one of them. طيب. If Alqama Ibn Waqqas said, قَالَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ. Imagine we remove the companion. If we remove the companion now, so what is the chain? Al-Bukhari, and Abdullah ibn Zubair, and Sufyan ibn Uyayna, and Yahya ibn Sa'id al-Qattan, and Muhammad ibrahim Taymi, and Alqama ibn Waqqas, then Alqama ibn Waqqas Laythi said, Qala Rasulullah, directly. We say this is Mursal. This is Mursal. Okay? Yani, we have, from the beginning, we have a complete chain, but at the end, the Tabi'i Arsala, he released the chain. Okay? So, what is the definition of the Mursal, the Hadith Mursal, when the Tabi'i says, Qala Rasulullah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Okay, some of them said, the definition of Hadith Mursal, if the companion is missing. But this is not correct definition. Why? Because if only the companion is missing, then it is an authentic chain. Why? Because the scholar said all the companions are authentic. In the chain, okay, we need to study the author of the book. He's authentic or not. He's just or not. Also, we need to study the sheikh. We need to study the tabi'i. Not all the tabi'i are just. Okay? But do we need to study the companion? He's just or not? His memory is strong or not? No. We don't study. I mean, in the books of hadith, okay? يعني for example, if you are preparing a master degree or a PhD, a book of hadith, okay? You study the hadith. Okay? What is the procedure? Okay, you mention the hadith with the chain. Then you start to study one by one. Okay, even the Bukhari, you have to put. What is the way? The way they put al-Bukhari. Okay, the first man in the chain. Or the first person, maybe it is a woman. Is it okay that a woman narrates a hadith? Yes. Okay. So the first one, number one, Bukhari. His name, Muhammad ibn Ismail ibn Ibrahim al-Bukhari. He is thiqah, he is just, his memory is like the mountain. Then they go to the second one, Abdullah ibn Zubayr al-Humaydi. Okay, he is the first sheikh of al-Bukhari. They will write something about him. But when they come to the companion, they say, Sahabi. That's it. Umar Khattab, Sahabi. Abu Huraira, Sahabi. Khalas. No need to write. يعني, yes, sometimes maybe they write, but there is no need. You don't need to write anything more than a companion, Sahabi. Khalas. Because if you write companion, it means he's just, he's tiqa, he's a pious. Khalas. Yes, they are human beings, but this is the way of the scholars of hadith. So if we say mursal means that the companion is missing, then it is an authentic chain. But the correct definition to say the mursal hadith means when the tabi'i says qala rasulullah. Okay, maybe someone say, okay, what is the difference between the two definitions? Both are the same. No, the difference is when I say that mursal hadith means when the tabi'i says qala rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, then who is missing here? We don't know. Yes, it can be sahabi, it can be tabi'i. Al-Hafidh ibn Hajar, one of the scholars of hadith in the 8th century, in the 9th century, he explained Bukhari. Okay, he said, I checked the mursal hadith. Okay, he said, I found a mursal hadith that 6 tabi'i are missing. 6 tabi'i. يعني between the tabi'i and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, 6 tabi'i and 1 companion. So that's why we say the mursal hadith is not authentic. The mursal hadith is not authentic. Why? Because we don't know how many people between the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and the tabi'i. If we know that it is only the companion, then it's okay. But if we are not sure, then we say this chain is not authentic. This chain is not authentic. Be careful. Sometimes they write, يعني in the books. I don't mean the books of hadith, but maybe a book of seerah, usually a book of seerah, or a book of stories. They mention a hadith, a narration. Then at the end they say, "Mursal sahih." I should bring the other cable. Sometimes you see this hadith is mursal sahih. Yani, I don't like this way for a book of seerah. Why? Because many people, or maybe most of the people who read the books of seerah, are not specialized. They are not specialized in hadith. Yani, of course, if you study the hadith, definitely you know what is the meaning of mursal sahih. But imagine your son, your daughter, your wife, they are not, or maybe you don't have any idea about hadith. Okay, so you think, it is written mursal sahih, so it is sahih. Okay, no, it is not sahih. What is the meaning of mursal sahih? It means, suppose this narration, okay, this is sahih Bukhari. Here the hadith from Abdullah Zubair, then from Sufyan, then So if you study this chain up to here, it is authentic. Alaykum salam. No doubt authentic, because all of them great scholars of hadith. But still it is mursal. So they say this hadith is mursal, but the chain is sahih. The chain is sahih. It is not connected, but it is sahih. So that's why it is very important to know the terms of the ahadith. Okay, يعني ال also يعني something also, I will not say common, but you see this. They say رجاله ثقات. After the narration, you'll find this hadith رجاله ثقات. Also, I don't like this way. Why? Because it shows the people that this is good hadith. This is authentic hadith. Again, if you are not specialized, you think this is authentic hadith. But this is not authentic hadith. Why? What about this chain? Can we say this chain, رجال وثقات, I mean, the narrators are just and authentic people? This chain? The people. Yeah, the people are authentic. Bukhari, Abdullah Zubair, these people are good people in hadith or not?
Yes.
They are perfect people in hadith. So if I say at the end of this narration, I say this narration or this chain is Rijal Uthiqat. Am I lying?
No.
Or this correct? Correct. Okay. Can I say this chain is authentic chain? No. Why? Because it is Mursal. It is Mursal, yes. There is something missing. The chain, because if you remember the definition of the authentic hadith, it should be connected, and it's not connected. So يعني, that's why to know the terms, okay, in the hadith very important. Okay, so this is a problem when you see, يعني, if you see, you are reading, for example, the stories of the prophets عليهم الصلاة والسلام, and then the narration you find رجال وثقات. Okay, رجال ثقات, then what? I need to know the hadith is authentic or not. The hadith is authentic or not. Also, okay, if you see Isnad صحيح. What is the meaning of Isnad صحيح? The chain is correct, authentic. But not necessary, the hadith is authentic. Why? No. This chain is not authentic. This chain is not authentic. But the men or the narrators are authentic. But if I say the chain is authentic, it means it is connected and the men are, or the narrators are, good. But there is possibility that it is shad. Shad, if you remember, what's the name shad? That the chain is okay. The chain is okay. But there is another chain which is stronger, gives another meaning or opposite meaning. So yes, the chain is authentic, but the hadith is shad. Difficult. From your faces. Huh? Brothers, I'm giving you something يعني, you can't find in the books. Because what is the aim that we are explaining briefly the science of hadith? To know these terms. When they mention رجال ثقات, is it authentic or not? No, not necessarily it is authentic. Okay, مرسل صحيح doesn't mean it is authentic. Isnad sahih doesn't mean it is authentic hadith. If you remember, يعني, remember the conditions of the authentic hadith. That there is musnad, there is a chain, and this chain should be connected. And the narrator should be adl, wadabat, the memory, and they are يعني, good Muslims. And there is no shudud and there is no illah. There is no a hidden problem. And also, it is not opposing something stronger. Shudud.
But this detail is not in the translation.
Which translation? No, in the books of science of hadith, you'll find. You'll find that. Huh?
The summarized one, it is not there.
Which summarized? Which one?
Sahih al-Bukhari.
Yes, summarized, yes, without the chain. Without the chain. That's why it is summarized from 7,000 hadith to 2,500, something like this. Now, I mean, the main point, it is important to know the terms. This will be very helpful.
Okay. It's not given these terms. Bukhari.
No, if you check the books of Mustalah Hadith, you will find.
No, but in English, maybe in Arabic all this is there, but in English they don't give such details.
Oh, you'll find. Yani, for example. Yani, for this book, Sheikh Ibn Uthaymeen, he has not many details, but it has yani, nice information. شرح بيقونية. It is in English, translated. Also, yes, this book, وصول حديث, شيخ بلال فيليبس. It has some details. Also, I have a third book at home. You'll find it in English. The third book, I forgot. But also, it is bigger than for شيخ بلال فيليبس. So you'll find some details. What is the meaning of mursal munqata?
No, he is talking about not the terms, but in there is a book.
You are his lawyer? Huh?
You can't say.
You can't say. I need a lawyer. Yes, tell me.
So what he is saying is that the books of Hadith, it is written, say, Bukhari or Muslim or whatever.
No, no. Okay. Okay. What I want you to know that it is important to know the terms, to understand the terms. Why? Yes, of course, they will not mention the details. Because now I want something practical. Are you specialized in Mustalah Hadith? You are not specialized. Also, not I'm not a scholar of Hadith to study the Hadith. This is authentic Hadith or not. But we need to know what are the meanings of these terms. Why? Because we see these terms in all the books. Books of Sirah, books of Fiqh, books of Tafsir. Maybe when you read Ibn Kathir, maybe you will find this the chain is authentic. Or the narrators are thiqa, authentic people, just people. Okay, or if you write the books of Sirah, you'll find this hadith is Mursal Sahih. Okay, so if you don't have any idea, immediately when you see the word Sahih, خلاص, it means it is authentic hadith. يعني, as if that some authors misguide people. Okay, يعني what is the problem? The problem, okay, if I am the author, I know what is the meaning of رجال وثقات. That it doesn't mean the hadith is authentic. I know what is the meaning of مرسل صحيح. It is not authentic. Okay, but as if I am cheating people. Okay, because imagine I write a book of Sira, okay, for the teenagers. And I put, after every hadith, I put, this is authentic hadith. This is not authentic hadith. And sometimes I come and I write, Mursal Sahih. Do you think that this boy or this girl can understand what is? So as if I am cheating. Yes, if the book for the, for example, for the students of Sharia, okay, give them. Because this is your job. Your job is, after writing the hadith, you have to put, your conclusion about the hadith. This is sahih, da'if, mutawatir, the chain is incomplete, complete. then the man can understand. Why? Because he is specialized in Sharia. But the problem when people write a book for the public and they put these terms, and he is sure that people will not understand. As if I consider this as if he is cheating people. Especially for the non-Arabs, it is in English. And he put, this is Mursal. This is Mursal Sahih. Even if he writes it, this is Mursal. What does it mean for Mursal? Tell me, please, this hadith is authentic or not? I think when he mentioned this hadith, Sahih. This hadith is not Sahih. I think it is clear for everyone. صح؟ But if I tell you, this hadith is mutawatir. Okay, what does it mean for mutawatir? This hadith, okay, the chain is Mursal Sahih. What is Mursal Sahih? Okay, so that's why we need to know. But about the details, this is a different story. The details can be found in the books of hadith, which study the hadith. Yani even not Al-Arba'in Nawawi, I don't mean the, yani for example, Al-Arba'in Nawawi. Even in Bukhari, you will not find Bukhari putting the every narrator, his author, he's just or not, and the chain. Okay. In Tirmidhi, yes, he mentioned some details. In Tirmidhi. Okay, he mentioned this hadith is authentic, this hadith is gharib, this hadith is this and this. Okay. So now, is it clear what is the meaning of Isnad wa Sahih? مرسل صحيح رجال ثقات عمر okay. Sorry, I will ask. Are you sure he knows or not? He knows, alhamdulillah. Well, this is important. Yeah. Well, I feel sad. I feel sad when I see in the books, for the public, they put these terms. Because I am sure people don't understand. I mean, not all people. Yes. Mursal Sahih, okay. We gave this example as Mursal. Okay, why it is Mursal? Because the Tabi'i said, Qala Rasulullah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Or the Tabi'i said, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did, or the Prophet said. So this is Mursal. We don't know how many people between Alqama and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We don't know. Suppose that we don't know. Okay. So this is Mursal, okay. Okay, this is Mursal, the second part. What about the chain here? Forget this part, okay? What about this chain? This is Sahih. So, up to Alqama from Bukhari or from the author of the book, up to the Tabi'i, what is the chain? Sahih. If you study this part, okay? You'll find, no, it is authentic. Why? Because there is a chain and it is connected and all of them are just. Okay, so this chain is authentic, but, this part from the Tabi'i until the author, authentic. But it is Mursal. Okay? Okay or not okay? Not okay? Mursal, if the Tabi'i said, Qala Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Sorry? No. Again, we cannot say. It is not a correct definition.
Sheikh, I think they came late when you explained the topic.
Okay. I know, I did not say this. Can we repeat for them or not? No, خلاص. طيب. So we mentioned معلق and مرسل. طيب. معضل and منقطع. طيب. منقطع, if there is عمر الخطاب. What is the meaning of munqati? Something cut. Munqati, if one in the middle. One in the middle, not here. Al-Bukhari, then Abdullah ibn Zubair, then Sufyan ibn Uyayna. After Sufyan ibn Uyayna, Muhammad Ibrahim. And suppose that the death of Sufyan ibn Uyayna, 200 Hijri. And the birthday, the opposite. The opposite. The death of Muhammad Ibrahim is 167 Hijri. And the birthday of Sufyan Uyayna is 200. So definitely he did not hear from. So there should be at least one person. At least. طيب. So we say this is munqata. Why? Because there is someone in between. Munqata. طيب. If two continuous or two people, طيب, two missing people, okay, then we call it معضل. معضل. معضل is, يعني, the meaning of معضل is something very difficult. يعني, as if منقطع, there is one missing person, maybe we can't find another narration, we can't. But imagine there are two generations are missing. Or يعني two narrators from two different generations, they are missing. Then it is معضل. طيب. So if the missing part from the beginning, it is معلق. If it is something missing from the end, مرسل. If it is missing from, يعني in between, منقطع. If there are two continuous people missing, this is معضل. معضل. Okay. يعني the point is there is something missing. Okay. And general name is منقطع. There is something missing. Someone missing. But there are different names. From the beginning, معلق. From the end, مرسل. In between, منقطع. Two people, معضل. معضل. Yes. More than two, also معضل. معضل. Three. Yes, we mentioned them. You mentioned them. Okay. But the general term, منقطع. Because مرسل also is منقطع. مرسل is منقطع. Okay. Also the معلق consider as منقطع. طيب. Are you happy? تمام. عمر. Ah, sorry. Rafiq said, تمام. خلاص. This is for you or for him? خلاص. الحمد لله. Sorry? حيا الله. Welcome. عبد الإله.
مرسل صحيح is not authentic.
Sorry?
مرسل صحيح.
No, not authentic hadith. مرسل صحيح doesn't mean it is an authentic hadith.
It can be or can't be.
Yes, you need to study more. You need to study. يعني مرسل صحيح until now it is not authentic hadith. إسناده صحيح still it is not authentic hadith. You need to study more. But usually when they mention Isnadu Sahih, they consider it as authentic. But it is not a proof that it is authentic. Why? Maybe it is Shad. The last point I like to mention about Mu'allaq. Okay? It is important to know in Bukhari, there are many Mu'allaq. Maybe 100 hadith, 200 hadith, Mu'allaq. Okay? They say Mu'allaqat al-Bukhari. Okay? You'll find in Bukhari, طيب, maybe you'll find chapter Kitab al-Salah. What is the main title? Al-Salah. Then the subtitle, Entering the Masjid. Bab Dukhul al-Masjid. Then he mentioned Ibn Umar used to enter the Masjid with his right foot. Okay? So this is Mu'allaq. Why? Because he did not mention his sheikh, the sheikh. Immediately he jumped to the companion, the sahabi. So the scholar said, this is mu'allaq. Okay, now the question, how come in Bukhari there is mu'allaq? Mu'allaq, it means da'if, not authentic. How come the scholars say Bukhari is authentic, everything in Bukhari is authentic? No, not everything in Bukhari is authentic. What the scholars mean when we say Bukhari is it is the second book. They say the second book after the Quran, Bukhari. They mean the ahadith with the full chain, all of them are authentic. But sometimes Bukhari mention hadith without chain. قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. Okay, this is mu'allaq. Or he said, Ibn Umar said this and this. Mu'allaq. Okay, so the scholars don't mean the mu'allaq hadith. This is a very important point. Why? Because sometimes ignorant people go to that. They open Bukhari. Okay, this hadith is not authentic. Yes, we know this is not authentic. So how come you say Bukhari, all the Bukhari authentic? You say all the hadith in Bukhari are authentic. Those which have chains, al-musnad. But when Bukhari mentioned, قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, or Abdullah ibn Umar said this, Anas ibn Malik said this about the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, this is a mu'allaq hadith. Maybe it is authentic and maybe it is not authentic. Al-Hafiz ibn Hajar, the scholar of one of the great scholars of hadith, he collected all the mu'allaq hadith in Bukhari. And he said, تغليق التعليق. Okay, all the mu'allaq hadith, okay, يعني if Bukhari mentioned hadith that the Prophet ﷺ said this without the chain or from the companion, Ibn Hajar collected all of these hadith. I don't know how many hadith, 500, 400. Then he made تغليق التعليق. يعني he filled the gap. And he told you at the end, this chain is authentic or not. Subhanallah. So this is very important to defend al-Bukhari, to defend Islam. Okay? I think this is enough. And more than enough. Huh? For today. Thiqa. يعني you mean the word ثقة includes both عدل and ضابط؟ يعني the term ثقة you mean includes the both terms؟
Yeah, for example, if you are telling about one Ravi, Ravi al-Hadith.
Huh?
He is ثقة. Means he contains both.
I don't know. We'll check this.